To heal means to have once been hurt. The term heal can come after the physical pain you endured after falling down and scraping your knee. Or perhaps it came after the emotional pain of losing a close loved one, like in my case. It all started on April 18, 2016. It started off as a normal day. I went to school like any normal teenager does, and I hated it. And then I had a softball game in Dassel afterwards. All was normal, but what was about to occur at home was all but normal for me. Today, I am thankful to be standing here after enduring so much emotional hardship that was almost too much to bear. It all started in November of my sophomore year when my grandfather died. I didn't want him to leave me, but I knew that he was in a lot of pain. I knew being in heaven wouldn't hurt or have him suffer anymore, but the hurt that he was feeling would be transferred to me in a different way. I became depressed and I stopped enjoying the things I once had. I think the number one reason for how severely depressed I was watching him die. I remember sitting at my grandma's house, enjoying the time with my family, and I remember hearing my grandma's voice yell, "Help." My whole family rushed into the room, not knowing what we were about to encounter. We knew it wasn't good. We knew that these were about to be his final moments with us. So we said our final goodbyes, we cried and consoled each other together. Being that his eyes had been closed for a few weeks because of the pain he was in, I hadn't known exactly when he died. But I remembered watching my uncle put his hand on my grandpa's heart. I watched his face, and he started to tear up, a sight that I had never seen before. I knew at that moment that I had lost my grandpa forever, and I wasn't ready to let that go. While my family went out of the room and started reminiscing about old times, I stayed in there for 2 hours. And I laid right next to him. I held his hand, the only warm part left on his body. I cried on his shoulder like I had done for the past 16 years. And I tried to thank him for everything he had done for me. So during that 2 hours, I had cried and cried and cried. And finally the nurses came. My dad and my grandma followed, knowing that I wasn't going to be ready to give him up. I saw the nurses, and I started screaming, and I started crying. And I wouldn't let go. I knew that it was his time to leave, but I wasn't ready to give him up. Maddie, stop. The nurses gave me one more minute with him, and I knew that in that minute, it was my last minute with him. So my dad and my grandma and both the nurses came back in, and my dad took this shoulder, and my grandma took this shoulder, and they pried me, but I kept screaming, I kept crying, and I kept kicking. The only thing left was my hand in his hand. And I finally let go, and I grabbed my dad and I hugged him, and I cried in his shoulders as I watched the nurses take him away. I stopped attending church after that. It was something that me and Grandpa did together, so I hated going. I had to figure out how to live without him, and to this day, it's still hard for me to do that. I was in such a dark place. My parents forced me to go to therapy, but I didn't open up. I hated going. I drifted apart from everyone, and I stopped communicating with certain people. So for 5 months, I was just barely getting by. And then on April 18th, 2016, I saw my grandfather's van being driven. Chad had been driven since he was alive. This was the event that drove me to try and kill myself. After not getting the results that I wanted, I went to a crisis center for 3 days. I didn't know it at the time, but I was on my way to my best, with a new outlook on life. After going through this, I figured new ways to cope with my stress and my grief. I started to open up to the people I care about again. And I started to regain the enjoyment I once had. I realized my worth and that my feelings and thoughts mattered. I started to speak about my experience at Celebrate Recovery and a healing service at my church. And that allowed me to help myself and others to know that it's okay. This experience has shaped me into the person I am today. Before getting help, I was suicidal, depressed, and a frightened mess. But after 3 days of rehab, I shifted negative thoughts into positive ones. I rebuilt my relationship with God, and I broke down the walls, which drove me to my rock bottom. I can honestly say that since the day getting out of rehab to right now, this has been my best.